right, we're here at my tiny worm bin, and today we are gonna count these worms and harvest these castings. Now, some of the stuff that I have in here, I'm just gonna set to the side. And this little toilet paper roll, Joe from Joe's Outdoor Places suggested maybe throw in a toilet paper roll straight down to try and wick up some moisture, and it looks like it did just that. I turned it over once, which is why you see some there, but that was a great little suggestion there, Joe. Thank you. So first thing we're gonna do before we do any counting or harvesting is kind of fluff this up and see how the worms are doing. Now, we've run into some mite issues the last couple times. In fact, when we started out, this bin has been through so much. When we first started, it was running really well, and then it got a little dry because we started in April and my air conditioning started working. Wow, I just gotta stop real quick. These castings are just absolutely fantastic. But anyway, the air conditioning started just kind of wicking all the moisture out of the air in my house. So what ended up happening was the bin got real dry. So eventually I started using some plastic over the top and that fixed it almost immediately. After that, we thought we'd get a little experimental. And what we did was we tried out some worm chow. We did that for a little bit and then I got really experimental and we put some pasta in this worm bin. And after that, that's when we started having issues because the feeding right after that was a sugary worm feeding. And then we just had mite issues. We had dates and I think some marshmallows. And after that, in the pasta, we had lots of mite issues. So here we go. We got some worms in there. Now we started with 612. So I think that we're probably going to have somewhere around the same because I think we have a carrying capacity reached last time we ran this worm bin. But I'll be real excited if we get anything more than that. So let's go ahead and put these in the same container here. That we put the paper. Now I know there's a couple worms on there, but I'll get those out. So after that, we kind of had our mite emergency and I tried to bait them out. And I think we got a lot of them, but there's gonna still be thousands more in here. So what we're gonna do after we count all these worms is we are gonna give them a bath to try and get as many mites off as possible. And then we'll restart this bin in a new video. So there you go again. Awesome, awesome amount of worms right there. Now you may be wondering, why are you getting rid of the worms? Why are you putting them back in here when you're trying to harvest? The way I'm gonna harvest is not the way I suggest you harvest. I'm gonna count them individually. And in order to count them individually, I can't really get them in a huge pile because then they tangle up and it's hard to detangle them. So I am gonna do this the long way. Picking them out individually, getting them into little piles, but not a huge pile like you could with a bin like this. And I see more worms on here, but I don't want to pick them off and pull them apart. So I think it was a couple feedings ago, we decided to use some of this bigger bedding because we didn't want to have the tiny shreds in here. And with those tiny shreds, it's really hard to pick out, you know, hundreds of little pieces of tiny shreds. So I stopped putting in the shredded cardboard for bedding, and I just put in these toilet paper rolls, which helped to do the job of absorbing some of the moisture out of the castings, which is what I needed to have done because this bin was way wetter last time, or I'm sorry, about 2 to 3 weeks ago. So it did its job. Oh my gosh, look at that worm ball under there. They've also eaten all the food that was in here. We gave them some strawberries and lettuce and a little piece of banana, all very fast food because we knew that we were gonna harvest. So last little piece, and then we'll get to the counting. Oh my gosh. Oh yeah, this bin wanted to give us one more worm ball before we finished up. Check that out. That is an awesome worm ball. In fact, I think I'm just gonna keep it there. I'm gonna keep it there. And I'll get some of these papers out as we count them because that will actually be helpful for me to count and speed things up for us. Now, as I count, I will fast forward and we'll take a look at what 100 worms, what 200 worms, you know, all the way up to our final count so you can kind of get an idea of how many worms look like in a pile. All right, so let's go ahead and dump this bin out. All right, pretty good job. We'll get the rest of that out. All right, I'll make sure I look through this for any kind of wisps, that kind of thing. All right, so there's our pile, and we are gonna start counting, and then we'll end up putting them in this container right there. 100. All right, so right in there is what 100 worms looks like. So if you're wondering what 100 worms looks like, right there, there's your 100 worms. All right, let's keep going. All right, so there we go. 200 worms right there. All right, let's keep going. 100. Wow, oh yeah, worm ball. But they tie themselves in a knot, so it's a little hard to get to them all. 300. All right, so right here is what 300 worms looks like, and we're starting to put in more castings that are coming along with the worms. But that right there is 300 worms. And as I was counting, the executive producer made a prediction. She said 701 is what she thinks we're gonna come out with. So there we go, 300 worms. Man, my gloves are getting real sticky. I may have to get another glove and I'll just rinse this and use it again, but the stickiness is making them stick. So I think I'm gonna get another glove. All right, got a new glove on. We will reuse all these gloves you see, but we are on 321. 400. All right, 400 worms right there. That's your look at 400 worms. And I haven't even got to this big pile right here, so I'm gonna guess that we're gonna be above 612, but there's 400 worms. There are a whole bunch of babies in this carrot right here, so I'm just trying to get them out. Come on, 46, get off my fingers. 100, wow. Or I'm sorry, 500. So here we go, 500 worms. I know a lot of people start with 500 worms. So that is about what 500 worms mixed with some castings looks like. 500 worms right there, 500. 600. Woo! How many minutes has it been?
50:27.
50 minutes to count 600 worms, and that's what 600 worms looks like right there. All right, 12 more and we'll have beat, or I guess 13 more and we'll have beat our last round. Oh yeah! We are definitely gonna beat them. Oh, executive producer is doing a jig because she's knows she's gonna get to 701. All right, let's count 13 out. 13. All right, there's 613. That beats our 612, and we have at least 100 or more left. Seven hundred worms right there. I think the executive producer said 701. So even she didn't count enough. So 700 worms right there.
800 worms. So this is what it looks like with 800 worms.
All right, thank you, executive producer, for counting the last 100. And oh man, these are heavy. That's awesome. I am so excited. 800 worms already. So let's go ahead and get through the home stretch. Nine hundred worms. Oh my gosh, look at that. 900 worms right there. We're getting really close to the end. I don't know if we'll make 1,000, but right there is 99 worms. Wow.
He said 99.
I meant 900 worms. What am I thinking? I am going delirious. We've been at this for more than an hour and 15 minutes. 96.
Oh my.
996? Are you kidding me? 996? No way. I've got to find more. I've got 4 more to find. We're going to do it. This is ridiculous. Somewhere in here has got to be 4 more worms. We have got to figure this out. Oh my gosh. I'm not going to stop at 996. No way. It's got to be a tiny worm somewhere. Oh. Here's one. Oh. Oh, look at that. Where'd it go? Oh, here we go. Shoot. 97, 98. Two more. Come on. Oh, oh. 99. Oh, come on. One more.
Check that carrot.
There's got to be something somewhere. Somewhere. Hello. Come on. All right, in the bin. In the bin. There's going to be something somewhere. There's going to be another worm. Oh, oh. 1,000! We did it! 1,000 worms in this tiny worm bin. This tiny worm bin had 1,000 worms. We started with 612, and I really thought that that was the max it can hold, but there's 1,000 worms right there, folks. If you are wondering what 1,000 worms look like, it is right in there. And oh my gosh, how painful to count that many. 1,000 worms. I think this is it. You are seeing the last time I will ever count a bin of worms. Oh my gosh. Okay, so as we were getting more and more towards the end, I was starting to see some mites. So I am going to bathe them. I'm going to let them settle down. I'm going to get some of the castings off of these and try and separate down to more worms. I'm going to give them a bath. And then we will be ready to start this tiny worm bin over again. Good job, worms! 1,000! All right, we're back and we're ready to set up to bathe the worms. Now, we did find a few more worms in here, so the final total is 1,008. So if you stayed this long, congratulations, you know the exact total of worms we found, 1,008. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try and get as much castings off of the top here, so we're down to mostly just worms. And if I pull a couple in here, I don't mind, but I don't think we will. Again, we're just trying to get rid of any kind of mites that might be in these castings. We'll never get them all, but we'll definitely get them to a lower population so that when we start this up again, that there just isn't gonna be a strong mite bloom if I run the bin too wet or if it gets too acidic, that kind of thing. So I'm just gonna keep doing this until I get down to mostly worms. All right, I think that's about as good as I can do. So what I'm gonna do next is I'm going to pour some water into here, into this basin right here. And this is just water that I got from my rain barrel. You can use water that you've set out for a little bit or water that you know doesn't have any kind of chlorine, that kind of thing. And actually you could use just regular tap water if you needed to in a pinch. But we're just gonna go ahead and set these worms in here. Now worms breathe through their skin. It's not like they have lungs or anything. So they are not gonna mind this water. And this is room temperature. You definitely wanna make sure it's room temperature. And again, the reason I'm doing this, you do not have to do this. In fact, I think I've only done this like one other time. Only reason I'm doing it is because I had a lot of mites and I just wanna stop the mite blooms. This is the third time I've run it and the last two times I've had some mite issues. Most of it caused by me when I'm putting in too much food at one time and letting it get too moist. All right, so as you can see, there are a lot of mites as a sheen on top of the water. So I'm just gonna kind of let this mix up a little bit and kind of let those mites float to the top just for a few seconds. And then I'm gonna go to the sink and I'm gonna rinse this down. I'm gonna put more water in, rinse it down until I get to the point where I'm happy enough that there aren't that many mites. And then we are going to restart this worm bin with these 1,008 worms. So I hope you're all having a great day. I hope your worm bins are doing well. So happy vermicomposting, everybody. Take care now.